Hello and a very warm welcome to the special edition of Rajya Sabha Television from the Regimental Centre of Jammu and Kashmir Regiment in Jabalpur. This regiment will soon complete 200 years of service to the nation. And in this report, I track their journey of grit, determination and valour. Come along.
The saga of glory and traditions of soldiers of sun and snow. Jammu and Kashmir Rifles Regiment has a unique history, closely intertwined with the state of Jammu and Kashmir and a special place in the Indian Army. Life in the armed forces isn't like any other. When you're protecting your country's borders 19,000 feet above the sea level at a temperature of minus 50 degrees at the Siachen Glacier, it can't be just another job. Neither is battling an average temperature of 50 degrees in the blistering heat of Rajasthan easy. Our soldiers aren't just fighting the enemies, they're also fighting natural disasters. At such high altitudes, frostbites, loss of memory and pulmonary problems are common. They're not working for the private gains. They're doing it for their country and for the citizens. The young men recruited by the regiment are raw boys. What they harbour is a burning desire to serve in the Jammu and Kashmir Rifles Regiment, to follow the glorious footsteps of their illustrious forebearers and to keep alive the celebrated tradition. During the training period, the candidates operate on little to no sleep and have a rigorous exercise routine to follow, including speed marches and runs with full battle load on their backs. And these routines are practiced every day for long hours. But as they cross the Antim Pagh, they're ready to be the finest fighting troops in the entire world. There is no bigger sacrifice known to man than to lay down one's life in the defense of the nation. In the war memorial, the valor, sacrifice and martyrdom is revered. Those who have laid down their lives in the service of the Corps and country in the pre- and post-independence era, including World War I and World War II, are remembered.
Last 200 years, there is not a single war where this regiment and its officers and soldiers have not taken part. More than 31 battles have been fought in last 200 years, and we have earned laurels in all of them. They are all depicted and they today form part of our crest, as you can see here. These are all our battle honors and the theater honors. In last 200 years, the regiment has seen three places. In after 47, the regimental center moved from Jammu to Gwalior and from Gwalior to Jabalpur in 1975.
Another unique feature of this regiment is that it fought both world wars with distinction, but was never commanded by any British officer, but by Indian State Forces officers.
The Jammu and Kashmir Rifles has a unique regimental history. Its antecedents go back to the Dogra Corps, raised by the intrepid Raja Gulab Singh of Jammu in 1820, under the suzerainty of Maharaja Ranjit Singh of Sikh Empire. General Zorawar Singh joined the army of Maharaja Gulab Singh as a soldier and rose to the rank of general. General Zorawar Singh led a strong Dogra force across Zanskar ranges for the conquest of Ladakh starting on 18th of August 1834. He campaigned for 6 years in the inhospitable terrain and conducted a series of hard-fought battles. Thus, Ladakh, for the first time in history, became part of India. He also led daredevil campaigns in the northern areas like Baltistan, Gilgit, Hunza, Yagistan, consolidating smaller principalities and making the northern areas as part of the expanding dominions of Gulab Singh. He also mounted a breathtaking invasion of Tibet in 1841.
The regiment saw action right after independence when Pakistan invaded Kashmir. The brave men showed exemplary courage and devotion to duty. It is widely said that it was due to their heroic act that India's map is what it is today.
After the establishment of Jammu and Kashmir as an independent princely state under the British Paramountancy in 1846, these troops became the Jammu and Kashmir State Forces. The Maharaja of Jammu and Kashmir maintained a larger number of state forces than any other ruler of an Indian state under the British Raj. These forces were organized into Jammu and Kashmir Brigades. Several of these units served with distinction on the northwest frontier of India and overseas during the Great War. The state forces fought as Imperial Service Troops in both the First and Second World Wars under their own native officers. They distinguished themselves in East Africa, Palestine, and Burma. The independence of India and the partition of the subcontinent saw a storm of change sweeping the state of Jammu and Kashmir. The firm stand of the state forces against the hordes of wild Afghan tribesmen recruited, trained and armed by Pakistan is well documented. On 21st of October 1947, the Jammu and Kashmir state forces were ordered to fight and push back thousands of Pakistani raiders all along its borders. The small troop, with limited ammunition, sans any road communication, they fought the raiders tenaciously. Brigadier Rajinder Singh, the chief of military staff, took over the command of a relief column and proceeded to check the raiders. The Indian Army joined the fight, and the J&K state was thus saved for India. For his devotion to duty, Brigadier Rajinder Singh was posthumously awarded the Mahavir Chakra by the then Army Chief Field Marshal K.M. Karyappa, thus becoming the first recipient of the Union of India Gallantry Award.
Due to their valiant actions in 1947 and 1948 in Kashmir operations, and also after Battle of Husainiwala in 1956, the entire regiment was amalgamated en bloc into Indian Army on 15th of January 1957 and was known as Jammu and Kashmir Regiment. In the year 1963, it was renamed or rechristened as Jammu and Kashmir Rifles.
Future of JACRIF before the Husainiwala battle was uncertain, but 19th March 1956 became a memorable day for Jammu and Kashmir Rifles. In early 1947, the Ratcliffe Commission had been established to deal with the disputes arising out of partition for both Bengal and Punjab. According to Commission's award, the Husainiwala headworks on the Satluj River and the area immediately around the Bund and the bank of the Pakistan side were allotted to India. On the right bank of the Bund, a stretch of 400 yards long and 30 yards wide, known as Bela, was under dispute with Pakistan. An outstanding moment known as Husainiwala action took place on 18th of March 1956. On this fateful day, a large force of Pakistan Regular Army launched a sudden, three-pronged, unprovoked attack. JACRIF was accordingly called in to defend the area and improve the defence works to boost up lowering morale of the civil works. Throughout the night, the Pakistanis launched several determined counter-attacks, but gallant men of JACRIF threw them back with heavy losses. It was the Husainiwala victory because of which J&K state forces were amalgamated en bloc into the Indian Army as a separate regiment.
The regiment has fought valiantly and gallantly under his leadership in the various terrains of Gilgit, Baltistan, Ladakh, Leh, including Tibet. And in fact, it is the only regiment which has to its credit of capturing a Chinese standard, that is the Mantalai flag, during the Battle of Purang in 1841. The regiment has also participated as the British Imperial Forces, but has never been commanded by any British officer till date.
No one can forget late Captain Vikram Batra of JACRIF, who had decimated the enemy through his heroic acts and the famous Dil Mange Mor, which had the entire nation fall in admiration of this war icon. Nicknamed Sher Shah, he, along with the Delta Company, decided to attack the enemy by surprise from the rear. At a height of 17,000 feet, Captain Batra and his men planned to approach the hill from the rear so as to take his enemy by surprise. As soon as they ascended the cliff and near the top, Pakistani troops pinned them on the mouth of the cliff with machine gun fire. But the brave Indian soldiers were undeterred by this, and Captain Batra and five of his men climbed up. Captain Vikram Batra alone killed three enemies in close combat, and despite being badly injured during the exchange, he regrouped his men and continued the mission. The point 5140 was captured at 3:30 a.m. on June 20th, 1999. He was given the nation's highest gallantry award, Paramveer Chakra posthumously for his outstanding courage, steadfast resolve, leadership and supreme sacrifice.
Jammu and Kashmir Rifle Regiment ka bahut hi gaurvshali itihas hai jisne har kshetra mein jo dushman ko bahut loha manwaya hai. तो इस रेजिमेंट का जो इतिहास है उससे इम्प्रेस होकर यहाँ पे इस रेजिमेंट ने गिलगित, बल्तिस्तान, हुंजा, लेह लद्दाख और दोनों वर्ल्ड वार के बीच में और उसके साथ 1947-71 की लड़ाई और साथ में कारगिल युद्ध के बीच में बहुत बढ़ चढ़ के हिस्सा लिया था. हालांकि जो कारगिल युद्ध है ये मेरे यहाँ पे उस वक्त में मैं फ़ौज में ज्वाइनिंग कर चुका था, लेकिन इस इलाके के बीच में जो हमारा इलाका है उसमें हर गांव का किसी कोई ना कोई एक है जो वो जम्मू एंड कश्मीर राइफल की तरफ में रेजिमेंट में जो भर्ती हुआ है.
Battalions of this regiment today have a class composition of Dogras, Muslims, Sikhs and Gurkhas who fought all the wars and also conduct counter insurgency operations.
The proud regiment of the Jammu and Kashmir Rifles owes its rich cultural heritage and strong military foundation to the diverse cultures it inherits in the form of its troops hailing from various sects like the Dogras, the Sikhs, the Gurkhas and the Muslims. The advantages of a mixed regiment are diverse and far outweigh the merits of a pure regiment constituting one community. All the 21 units of the regiment have a different class composition, varying from pure single community units to two communities to a fair mix of all four communities. This has aided the regiment in excelling in all spheres of military domain by harnessing the positives and strong characteristics of each community. All the four communities form the pillars of the regiment and are a true example of unity in diversity as they bond together in keeping the colors of the regiment flying high.
सबसे अच्छी खास बात यह है कि इसमें सभी गोरखा, डोकरा और सिख और मुस्लिम सभी आपस में मिलकर सीआई ऑपरेशंस में या फिर पीस एरिया में कंपटीशन में भाग लेते हैं और अच्छा प्रदर्शन करते हैं.
मैं हिमाचल स्टेट डिस्ट्रिक्ट बिलासपुर जहाँ से जनरल जोरावर सिंह कहलूर वहाँ के रहने वाले हैं, उनकी वीरता की कहानी हम बचपन से सुनते आए हैं और हमारे इलाके का हर आदमी उनसे रिलेट करता है. मेरे पिताजी खुद इस सेना में 30 साल जिन्होंने 1971 का वॉर और वॉर मेघदूत के बीच में हिस्सा लिया और मुझे अपने आप को बड़ा सौभाग्यवाली फील करता हूँ मैं जब मैं सोचता हूँ कि मैंने जैक राइफल के बीच में मुझे सेवा करने का मौका मिला.
The Indian Army's participation in the UN peacekeeping operation spans a period of 57 years, covering 43 UN missions in which over 90,000 Indian soldiers have served in various parts of the world. Indian troops have taken part in some of the most difficult operations and have suffered casualties in the service of the United Nations. Professional excellence of the Indian troops has won universal admiration. India has taken part in the UN peacekeeping operations in 4 continents. Its most significant contribution has been of peace and stability in Africa and Asia. Jackriff Regiment has had the honor of representing the country 7 times till now in various United Nations missions. All the battalions have done the nation proud and have come back with many laurels on foreign land.
शुभ कर मन ते कब न डरो.
जैक मिलिट्री बैंड इज वन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट बैंड ऑफ द आर्मी व्हिच वाज रेज्ड इन मार्च 1932 अंडर द एजीस ऑफ महाराजा हरि सिंह द देन रूलर ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर स्टेट.
निश्चय कर अपनी जीत
Military band's presence rendered a colorful identity to all the state functions with a regal performance. Thus, Jat Military Band is colorful and vivid as army and its soldiers, with many laurels to its credit. With the integration of the entire regiment, the band was also integrated with the army bands of the Indian Armed Forces. The band has played a unique role both in peace and war of motivating and raising the morale of troops. Jammu and Kashmir Rifles Regiment will soon celebrate 200 years of selfless service and sacrifice to the nation. The bicentenary celebrations will be held in Jammu. A series of events will be organized on the occasion with pomp and gaiety and will be attended by a large number of serving and retired officers, veterans and Veer Naris.
Please do not mistake it to be another celebration of some sort. It is our expression of, you know, gratitude, expression of present generation, gratitude towards the past generation. That is one. Secondly, it is also a promise. It will be showcasing a promise or commitment to carry forward their legacy, their tradition and culture to the future generations. And as far as how are we going to go about it, firstly, the celebrations are woven around 13th of April, which is the birthday of General Zorawar Singh, the indomitable general, who is also called Little Napoleon of India. We have planned number of events.
The Jammu and Kashmir Rifles holds a distinct place in terms of honours and awards amongst the infantry regiments of Indian Army. The regiment is proud of its two Paramveer Chakra, the highest gallantry award in war, and two Ashok Chakras, the highest gallantry award in counter-terrorist operations. In addition, the regiment also distinguishes itself with 5 Mahavir Chakras, 11 Kirti Chakras, 44 Veer Chakras, 46 Shauri Chakras and 313 Sena medals. In pre-independence awards, the regiment holds 1 Victoria Cross amongst a plethora of gallantry awards. Hailing from a family with army background, many represent the third generation in the Jammu and Kashmir Rifles.
I belong to Jammu and Kashmir. My grandfather, Thakur Dewan Singh, he served the state forces before independence. Carrying the baton forward, my father, Colonel C.D. Singh Sena Medal, joined the forces in 92 and is still serving Jammu and Kashmir Rifles. I also followed in his footsteps, and on 7th December 2019, I've been commissioned to 12th Battalion, the Jammu and Kashmir Rifles, that is my father's regiment. So as it completes 200 years, it is my duty and it is my I am fortunate enough to say that I'll be carrying the baton forward and serving the state and the state forces.
And the saga of grit, determination and courage continues. But that's all I had for you in this edition of Rajya Sabha Television. With camera person Jitendra Negi and Kriti Mishra, signing off from Jabalpur.